So in this video, I'd like to cover some of the quadrat tools in the modeling toolkit. They have a few similarities to the tweak tools inside of Softimage, and of course some other features that come from a variety of different tools, but they're all kind of combined into one. So I figured it would be a good topic to cover. To start off with, typically what you want to do is bring in whatever it is. This is just a quick sculpt that I brought in from Mudbox. I just did a little sketch of this kind of alien guy. And you can see what I've brought in here. I've got about 6.5 million triangles, and it's moving fairly fine in here. So this is a reasonable example. I'm just going to switch over to the modeling toolkit, which if it's not currently on, you can go under Windows, Settings and Preferences, Plugin Manager, and find your way down to the M's. So modeling toolkit, you can turn that on. That should show up here. And it's available simply by going ahead and clicking this button here. And once it's been opened, it'll show up on the side panel here. Also, if you go into the preferences, either from this button or under Windows, Settings and Preferences. You also have access to this little panel here under the category of Settings, Modeling Toolkit, and at the very bottom, if you drag it down, you have the current hotkey settings for these guys. Now these don't exist in the main hotkey window. They exist primarily here. They've got some drop-down options for what happens with left mouse button, etc. This is because essentially it's a separate engine within here that's doing something different. It's thinking about things in a different way. So let's see how that works. So if we go ahead and drop into Quadrat Tool with nothing selected, it will allow us to start creating a new mesh. If you have an existing mesh selected, it will continue to build off of that existing mesh. So we're just going to go ahead and drop in a few points, just like so, and you can see these green points here. If I hold down Shift, it'll allow me to create a polygon in there, and I can continue, of course, to add to that as I will. Alternatively, I also have the possibility of holding down Tab. So if you're in 2015, you can use Tab for this. If you're in 2014, the hotkeys will be a little bit different. And if I drag this around, you see I've got this trailing polygon here. And if I just click and drag, it goes ahead and does this. But you have to be careful about changing direction. You can see what happens here. They start to overlap each other. So you have to be careful when you're using it. So you go ahead and you take it and you align to what you want. If you determine that it's too large, you can use your middle mouse button and drag to change the size of the potential strip. So if I go ahead and bring this over here, align that, and then I'm going to click and drag. I get myself a little strip. Hold on Tab again. Close to what I want, and then click and drag. And there we have that. I'm just going to use, without pressing any hotkeys, I get basically the tweak function. So the tweak function allows me to go ahead and grab points and move them, or grab faces or edges. It's a multi-component mode, which is why I say it's kind of like the tweak tool inside of Softimage. And then if I'm not clicking on the mesh, I get to create more points. So if you click on the mesh, it'll move them, but if you click off, it creates new points. And again, I'll just hit Shift to create that polygon, this one there, and that's connected. It's all ready to go. Now I want to extend this out a little bit. So again, I'm going to use my Tab key, which gives me this stuff. But if I click on an edge instead, it allows me to drag it out. Now that's clicking and dragging out this stuff. If I use the middle mouse button, I got this shape. But what if I use the middle mouse button on an edge? I click and drag that out, and I get the rest of the loop. Now, when I bring this close, you'll notice that there's a snap. And this functions as a weld, an automatic weld. So if I were to go ahead and just drag out this point right here, I could do it initially, or I could do it in just movement afterwards. And just bringing it close enough will cause it to snap. And of course, that then becomes one singular point. So it automatically welds the stuff for you. I'm going to go ahead and Control and Shift and delete this guy because I don't actually want him. So Control and Shift will allow you to delete edges and our edge loops. You can see edge loops. So it's going to grab loops. And of course, individual faces. And of course, if you have any floating points. So if I make a floating point here and go over that with Control and Shift, left click, that will delete it. Control and Shift, when you use your middle mouse button, however, on an edge, will allow you to drag that entire edge loop. So rather than just grabbing a single edge, you can grab the entire loop. So Control Shift, middle mouse button, and drag. I'll do that. If I use just Control and left mouse button, I can tap in some edge loops here. And that will fill out that section. And I get something like that. I'm going to go ahead and let's see, I'll pull out some more. So I'll just drag this guy out, and this guy out. Let's see, how about him as well? I'll snap those together. Pull out these points, get them nice. And then I'll go ahead and control click that to go ahead and start building that form. And then adjusting it how I want. Get that border working. So now that I got the border working, for the most part anyways, I want to go in and adjust these points, but I don't want to tweak them one at a time, gradually moving them. I want to tweak them in a way that'll smooth out nicely. So if I hold down the Shift key, I can go ahead and drag across them, and it will go ahead and adjust those points. Now you notice it doesn't do anything to the outside edge currently, the way that the settings are set, so it will only do the interior. And if I go along the exterior, so right along the open edge, you can see that I can adjust these guys as well, and then go back on the interior. So let's say I'm happy with this so far. I'm just gonna go ahead and see, I'll hit a point there, right there. There, I'm changing the direction of the flow of the polygons. There we go. Maybe that needs another point. Go ahead and tweak some of that.